Did not overcome it. brokenness, even death, cannot extinguish the great, radiant light of Christ. Thanks be to God. And now will you join me in this call and response? We come to you hungry, O Lord. For justice.
We are fed by Christ, who is the light of the world.
You may stay seated
while we sing this song over you, and I encourage you as we sing this song to pray the prayer at these words.
Thank you.
Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
We are surrounded by lies. Too often, politicians tell us that war and violence will bring peace. Too often, our neighbors put on a happy face to hide the pain of their reality. Too often, we don't even know ourselves, and we convince ourselves of things that are simply not true. For instance, we believe sometimes that we are never at fault. Or we are always at fault. And even when we're well-intentioned, we hide things even from ourselves. Like the psalmist in Psalm 19, we cry out, but who can discern their own errors? Forgive my hidden faults. And even when we can sift through all of that mess, we still run into mysteries too deep for us to understand, a world too complex for us to grasp. And our anxiety rises because we yearn for certainty. I know you've felt it over these past few years, just as I have. The world feels less certain, and the right path less clear. In John 14, Jesus gives his disciples this incredible word of hope we just heard. That where he is, they will be, that he will go and prepare a place for them. But Thomas still can't wrap his mind around it. What is Jesus talking about? How can we be sure that there is any hope? How can we really feel like we have a strong foundation to stand on when we know that we are so limited as human beings? How can we possibly discern the truth amidst so many lies? We are hungry, we are starving for it. How can we know the way? I am the way, the truth, and the life, Jesus responds. We come to this place hungry. We wonder whether we can know anything about ourselves, our world, and our God for certain. And Jesus responds to our hunger. He says that he can serve as our guide to the Father. He is the measure of truth. He is the way to follow. And he brings life and light to those who are in darkness. Thanks be to God. Would you join me in this call and response? We come to you hungry, O Lord, for we know that righteousness is the bread of life. We hunger for truth.
And we are fed by Christ, who is the way.
Will you stand and join us?
divine, and my Father, his divine brother. Abide in me as I abide in you all. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you all unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you all are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit, because apart from me, all of you can do nothing. If you all together abide in me, and my words abide in all of you, ask for whatever you all wish, and it will be done for all of you. My Father is glorified by this, that you all bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved all of you. Abide in my love. If you all keep my commandments, all of you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said all of these things to you so that my job may be in you all, and that my joy may be in you all together, and that the joy of all of you may be complete. From John 15.
Of our being long to be known, to be loved. And so Christ beckons us to abide. He declares that he is the vine, the life-giving connection that sprawls throughout the garden, the source that provides connection and nourishment to all who are united to him. And we collectively are the branches. We together are to abide in his love, to dwell and to remain in his love, to endure with one another in his love. In John chapter 15, the you in Jesus' words is plural. This is my commandment, that you all love one another as I have loved all of you. The urging is to abide in him, not given to one individual, as to say that each person should abide in Christ individually or on their own. No. It is the community together who is called, you all are the branches. You and me and them and all of us who claim Christ as our own, we are the community of branches connected to the vine. We are the people of God who abide in Christ's love together. We are called not only to love God, but to love one another, and to do so deeply, fully, and in community. Would you join me in this call of response? We come to you hungry, O Lord.
We know that Christ is the bread of life.
We hunger for community.
Found here at the table. Holy communion with God and with one another. Here we meet Jesus, the one who satisfies our hunger, the one whose sacrifice we remember tonight, the one who said, I am the bread of life. Whoever believes in me will never go.
And so, on the night that our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, he took the bread. And after giving thanks for it, he broke it. And he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you."
In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. And he said, "This cup is the new covenant poured out for you, my blood. All of you drink from it. For every time that you drink of this cup and eat of this bread, you are proclaiming the Lord's death until he comes again." For communion, we're going to ask you to come forward row by row. There's going to be three stations that our elders from Maple Ave and Calvary are going to serve. If you need gluten-free bread, that station will be the one right here. We're pointing to your left of the table here. We ask that the elders are going to take the bread and hand it to you. So you just put your hands in a posture of receiving, just to receive God's love right now and to hear those beautiful words. This is Christ's body broken for you. I would ask that our elders would come forward to prepare.
Friends, our communion is in the body of Christ, in this bread. And the cup of blessing which we bless is our communion in the blood of Christ. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Come, for all things are good.
Thank you.
have come to the cross.